What have you been doing since the NFL days? What are you doing these days?
All right, so since the NFL, I became a motivational speaker. I wrote a book, and then also a TV analyst for college football.
What's going on in college football? A lot. I mean, Nebraska just got rid of their coach.
And they're playing the USC Trojans. That's really interesting, right? They hired Mike Riley from Oregon State. It should be exciting to see what the bowl game brings. But I think what's going to be really cool is obviously the playoff system. You know, this is the first year they're having the four teams, and then it goes to two. So it'll be interesting to see Alabama play. Who's number four? Ohio State, and then you have Oregon playing Florida State. So yeah, it'll be awesome to see.
What's tougher? What's more exciting? NFL or college?
Well, obviously, the amount of money you can make in the NFL is exciting. But I think, obviously, the implication that every game and every week has is extremely important at the college level. And so you really can't take a game off because you could drop, as we've seen this year with TCU and all these other schools that have fallen out of the top five. And then they've been basically eliminated from the playoff scenario.
My last question, you're a motivational speaker. How have you seen people's lives change after you talk to them?
That they believe this. I have a saying. My company has a saying. For you. So I can, I will, I did.
Mm-hmm.
And I give this to you.
Oh, I appreciate
it.
Thanks so much.
Every time I've had an opportunity to speak, they actually believe that they can. And just my story, being able to share with them and empower them and not just talk to them and entertain them, but actually giving them tools that I use to go from a hopeless kid with no future to receiving a full ride and scholarship and actually playing in the NFL and seeing my dream become a reality.
How did you do it? I mean, why didn't you give up?
Because I had my sixth grade teacher who was betting against me. He told my mom by the time I was 16, I would be dead, shot, stabbed, and a leader of a gang.
Why would you say that?
Well, he said it, obviously. I don't know, but he motivated me. So maybe I'm responsible for paying him a couple of dollars and telling him thanks.
But you took it one way, but another kid may go the other way and
right.
Get in the gang and show them, oh, I'm in a tough, you know?
Right, yeah. So the easiest thing for all of that is to say, well, who's important to you, right? So for me, it was my mom. And I wanted to turn her joy, tears of pain and hurt and sorrow into tears of joy. So we did that when I graduated high school, graduated college, and then played in the NFL.
Your book, for those who want to purchase it, what's the name?
Permission to Dream.
And where do we find it?
Amazon and my website, www.thomasrwilliams.com.
There you have
Fight
it.
Fight on.
There you have it. USC, BusinessReporting.com. I'm Mike Sipak reporting.
Come on.